Hey guys, and welcome to another episode. Today in this video, I'm going to be completely upgrading the coolant system on the Mini. One of my parts fell. So what's going on today? I'm going to be replacing everything except for one part. So right now I have one little coolant leak, and I showed you guys before, it's found on the back side of the motor, right before the coolant pump. So right down there, there's a water pipe that connects from the thermostat, from this end, goes across the motor, and the water pump is found back there. Now there's a leak between the water pump and the thermostat, so the little pipe that's in there is broken. And I've got a new one right here. This is the new pipe that's gonna be going on, along with everything else. So I have all new, if you can see right here, silicone Mishimoto coolant lines. Every single piece is gonna be replaced. I have an aluminum expansion tank. I have a metal coolant pump as opposed to the plastic one that comes stock on the car, and I bought a replacement thermostat. So all of this stuff is going on the Mini. Now hopefully at this point, everything in the coolant system except for the rad is gonna be changed over, and it's gonna make sure that everything is gonna be running properly. I'm not gonna have any leaks. Now my only concern is that I might need to upgrade the rad down the road, say if I track the car. However, once I get in that situation and maybe I see the car start to overheat, only at that point will I upgrade it. Now I honestly have not found any kind of rad for the car to replace the OEM one. Now I don't have any problems with it. However, I'm gonna leave it like that and I'm gonna just get started with everything else. So on the back side of the motor, I took off the intake manifold, the throttle body, and everything back there. Now I'm gonna be straight up with you guys. I'm probably not gonna show you everything in this video because this is a pretty big job, but I'm gonna give you a rundown as to what's going on. So that pipe that I had, the one that's broken, right here, is broken at this end. So this plastic snapped, cracked, or whatever, and now I have a leak over here. So that O-ring is not doing a good job at sealing the coolant that circulates inside of the pipe to the coolant pump. Now, with that being said, this piece needs to come out. And if you can tell, this is not a flexible line like one of these. See how you can bend that? Well, you can't exactly do that with this, and that is a huge problem for me. So I either need to remove the coolant pump or remove the thermostat. That is how I replaced this piece. Now, if it was a squishy pipe like this, I wouldn't really need to do anything that extensive. However, that's not the situation. So I was like, okay, what do I do now? Well, I could take out one of them and hopefully, you know, not run into any other problems. However, just to play it safe, I'm gonna be changing out the coolant pump on this end and the thermostat on this end. Now, I'm gonna start off and work on the thermostat over here, which is found under there. And I already started taking out some of the electrical wirings and everything because, you know, this engine is pretty small, but the engine bay is even smaller. So everything in this engine bay is crammed in there tight. So I've already taken out the headlights. Well, if you can see from the hood, headlights are out. This pipe that was down there for the intake is out. The intake is all removed, the manifold, the throttle body, everything down here. So this way I've got a lot more room to work with, and I'll hopefully be able to tackle this job. So the thermostat down there needs to be removed. Each one of the lines that are connected to it, all of those are getting replaced. And if you remember from my previous video when I showed you how to install them on the Accord, I replaced all of the rubber lines for the coolant system with blue lines. And I did the exact same thing for the Mini. Now, the reason why I went with blue is because, you know, I'm replacing the coolant pump along with all the coolant piping. Now, coolant is pretty much water, so I thought, okay, let's distinguish this very easily. Any blue line is for coolant, and any other color line is for the air. So for the intercooler, the piping, all of that stuff. So I still have intercoolant piping in here, and it goes up from here to the bottom side down there where you can't see, but I'm gonna be changing out all that stuff as well. So it's gonna be very easily distinguishable when you take a look at the engine bay. Red is gonna be the air, blue is gonna be the coolant. Now, let's get to it. So to give me a little bit more room, I'm gonna remove the expansion tank from the car. Now there's an 8mm bolt found on the top of the expansion tank that holds it in place. So this you take out and you lift up on the entire thing. It'll slide forward and you can lift up on it. Now, from here, you're gonna have two clamps. You're gonna have one up top right there, and you're gonna have another one on the bottom side. Now, I went ahead and already loosened up that, so I should be able to pull that apart once I put the camera down, and the same thing for the bottom. Now, the bottom is slightly different. See that little metal piece? Well, I have to slide that out, and then I'll be able to pull down on that piece. And then with it out, you can lift up and slide this down. Just like so. And we're gonna put that aside. Now we need that cap. Now the new piece that we got, the new expansion tank, does not come with it. So we need to save this and reuse that. Now I'm gonna take it off right now, just so I don't lose it. But I'm not gonna install the new one yet. You can see right now that there's a lot more room to get access to all those coolant lines. Now next up, all of those lines that have coolant in it, we need to remove. Now I showed you guys in the previous video when I installed the silicone lines on the Accord, all that we're doing is we're taking off each one of those clamps on both ends. We're gonna take those out, slide them down the line, and then at that point we can take out the rubber line and replace it with a silicone one. Now we're not gonna be installing them yet, we're just gonna be taking everything apart so we can get access to the thermostat. Alrighty, so here we are now. We've got the coolant line going up to the expansion tank removed. We've got the two coolant lines that were going from to and from the rad, we have those disconnected, and the two lines going to and from the heater core disconnected. Now all of those were connected up at the thermostat housing. Now for the Mini, it's all one big unit, and I can show you what it looks like right here. So this is it. This is our replacement one. So we have the two lines up front, we have another one underneath, two more at the back, and then this one right here that's connecting to our water pipe, which is the piece that broke on our car. So where are we at now? We've got to remove the three bolts found underneath there that connect. One, two, and three that connect the thermostat up to the block. So to do that, I'm going to be using a 10 millimeter ratchet with a socket at the end of it to get each one of those out. Now once you have all three of those bolts removed, you can set those aside, and the thermostat should be able to be removed once you just pull on it. So from underneath here, we're gonna wiggle the thermostat back and forth. And right now it's free. So I'm gonna put the camera down and pull it out of the car. So a few swear words and a little bit of stress later, we can take our thermostat out of the car. Now you can see that it's out, but I mean, even still, it's not that nice to work with. So this is our old thermostat, and you can see all the junk found on the inside. Now I'm gonna set that aside. I'll come back to that in a second. But once we did that, I was then able to come back here and I just removed the water pipe, which is the pipe that was sandwiched in between the thermostat and the water pump. Now, I found out what the issue was. Now on this side, you can see that it's all corroded. And you can see there's a little bit of mineral deposits found on the end of it. On this side, on the inside of it, there's nothing, and that's normal. However, over here, you can see that there's a rubber seal. And this rubber seal makes a nice watertight little gasket for these two pieces to mesh together. Now, the same thing should be here on this side. Now, when I took it out, there was no seal, no nothing. And that's why I had the leak. So this is the old one, and this right here is the new one. That little rubber gasket is the reason why I had a huge coolant leak. All right, now next up, I'm gonna be moving up to this piece, and this is the water pump. This is what makes the coolant circulate in the engine. Now, this right here, this little circular part, which is like kind of like a little fan, that is the impeller. And this is what actually drives all of the coolant around the engine. So it's attached on this side to the accessory belt. So there's a pulley on this side with the accessory belt going around it. And that is what turns this side, which in turn turns the impeller. Now the reason why I went with this one right here with the metal impeller is because the OEM one from BMW, the impeller is actually made out of plastic, and that is prone to fail. So I figured while I'm at it, why not replace all this stuff all in one shot? Now to make sure I've got a nice seal, there's a little O-ring, a little rubber O-ring found on the outside of it, just to prevent any coolant from leaking off. However, this right here is gonna be making my car nice and cool. Alrighty, so I kind of fast forward a little bit. Right now, I've got installed all the coolant lines that we replaced. Now, the coolant lines, so the one going to the reservoir is hooked up, the ones going to and from the thermostat that lead right up to the rad, all of those are replaced. And if you can see down there, there's even the one found on the bottom part of the rad. Now, I removed the front bumper to get access to it.
And if you can see right there, there's the one coolant line. That's for the lower part of the rad. And in order to get the clamp off of there, I had to remove the intercooler found at the front. And in order to do that, I had to take off the bumper. Hence why the car looks like this. However, it's kind of setting me up for what I'm going to be doing soon. Now, once I have all these coolant lines in, the coolant system is going to be good to go. But with the car like this, with the intercooler removed, this leads me to the next step. And that brings me over here. So right here are all new silicone intake piping hoses. So I've got ones to replace, you know, every single one attached to the turbocharger. So the ones leading to and from the intercooler, the ones that are attached right before the throttle body, they're all getting replaced. So all of the blue lines are for coolant, and I figured I'd keep all those blue, you know, because it's coolant, water, blue, whatever. And then for the red ones are all gonna be for the air, if the camera will focus. So I'm gonna have a nice contrast between the blue and the red. So I took out the hard piece of the intercooler piping found in here, and I had to disconnect these two bolts and the one there, so I could lift this up, push that out of the way, because there was an intercooler piping going through here, down there, up to, the intake manifold. And then from there, we're gonna be able to install that. However, the install for all the coolant stuff is pretty much done. So I've got all the coolant lines, the thermostat in, that pipe found on the back, I've got that sandwiched in. One sec, where are we? Right back there. So there's that new pipe, and I put a little bit of lube on the end of it so it would slide in. Now, these are all of the old pieces. So I've got all of the old lines. This is our new, the aluminum water pump. I didn't install it because I didn't have to get access to this, because everything that I replaced was found on this side of the engine. Now, the coolant pump and the accessory belt and all that stuff is found on this side. So from down here, the coolant pump is found a little bit higher than that. There's my crankshaft, there's my accessory belt. The serpentine belt needs to be removed in order for me to access the coolant pump. Now, it's not broken, it hasn't died on me yet, but I'm probably gonna install it in the future just as a precaution, because I heard that the water pumps on these minis and most German cars like to go. So the car's at 120,000 clicks, and I'm gonna just be, you know, just making sure that the car isn't gonna be taking a crap on me when I'm driving. Now, I don't know if it's just my luck or the kit that I bought, but I've noticed that I've had to trim up a couple of these hoses because they're a little bit too long. Now, it's better that they're too long than, you know, too short, but it's still an inconvenience because I've had to grab my scissors and trim off a little bit. So, like, this hose that I have right here is what connects from there to the expansion tank. And I just tried to hook it up, but because the line is so much longer, it doesn't quite fit so nicely. So I've just got to trim up a little bit on each end, but it's just, you know, it's an extra step that I have to do. I don't know if it's because of my generation car that, I don't know, Mishimoto made, but I've had to trim up, I want to say, almost every one. Now, it's not too much of a hassle, but it's just an extra step that I need to do. So, yeah, just been trimming up a little bit and then burning the end with a lighter. Now, you guys know it's a little annoying. Okay, so right here I've got the one line going to the expansion tank, the second one is gonna hook up into there, and the expansion tank is gonna sit right over here. So it sits inside there, there, and you bolt it in and secure it with this. Now, the annoying part is that the aluminum one that I picked up from eBay, it doesn't quite fit, and I'll show you why. So see this right here? This is for my shifter. So this needs to go down and up along with left and right. Now, it doesn't want to fit only because, see this part right here? This nipple is where the coolant will come out of the bottom from, and it's going to connect up using this piece. So this sits on the bottom of it. Now, because this part here is pushed so much out from this part here that sits in right, where's that hole? Right in there. So that little part sits in there. So that holds it in place. And this is where the coolant comes out from. Now, if you take a look at the OEM one, you can see that that's where it hooks up into, and the port for the bottom part of the expansion tank is very close to this. Now, what that does is it keeps this little hose right here not pushed into the engine bay. It keeps it right up against the wall. Now, when you put it out here, there's not enough room when I install this on the car. So I'm just gonna take this out and show you guys, because I was really hoping to install it and have it mounted on the car, because it looks a lot nicer than the faded plastic one.
but that's not gonna happen. I might have to return this and then pick up a new one. So the way it works is, oops, you install it like that. It hooks in to there, and then from underneath, you just push that in place. So it looks there, it looks nice. It's a lot nicer than the OEM one, but the one problem, and I'll see if I can pick it up on camera, see how much further out that is? So that little nipple on the bottom of the expansion tank should be a lot closer to there, because when you grab, oh, it's really difficult to see, but see down here, see this? This is very close, and there's not enough room when you actually install this hose onto it for it to work. So what I'm gonna have to do is I'm gonna have to reinstall this, keep that on there for now, and then down the road, once I get a new expansion tank, I'll go ahead and throw that on. But as it stands, that's out. I can put this back in, put coolant in the system, and then everything should be good to go. So it sits there like that, goes in place. See how much more room there is? So from down here, that can move freely, and look at how much more room I have for the bottom part of that hose to connect to. Lots of room. So I'll have to keep that on there for now. But as it stands, we've got those coolant lines in. We have the smaller one right there. We have the ones coming down to the rad hooked up. Now, unfortunately, I couldn't find any silicone hoses that go to the heater core, but I might be removing the heat and the AC down the road, so I don't know. We'll see how this goes. It could be a good thing. I don't know. But as it stands, that's how you remove all those little silicone, the OEM ones, the little silicone hoses, and replace them with the nicer ones. So these ones only have one little cord on the inside. If the camera will focus. See how there's like a couple threads in there? Well, the new ones are a lot nicer. Look at all the reinforcement found on the inside of this one. So that's why I upgraded, and these are Mishimoto lines. I'll have links in the description box, as always, guys, if you guys want to pick up anything that I use today. So I'll just set that down, take this out, and then hook that up. So then as it stands, we can go ahead and open up our expansion tank, put our screw back in here, and then we should be able to go ahead and just fill up all of this with our coolant, and then our coolant system is going to be good to go. Now, I can't quite yet go ahead and turn on the car and bleed the coolant system, only because I don't have any other parts of the intake system installed. So you can see that the turbo isn't really attached anywhere. I don't have, on the back side of the motor, I don't have my intake manifold, my throttle body, any of the intercooler piping that goes down there. The intercooler is removed because it's, well, it should actually be in that place. So all of this needs to be reinstalled on the car before I can go ahead and bleed the cooling system. Now, I'm not going to quite do that yet, only because I'm going to be going ahead and installing new piping, new silicone piping, just like you saw today. So see this coolant stuff? Well, I've got now all this piping right here for the intake system. Now, on top of that, I have this, and this is a larger intercooler that's going to be mounted in place of where the OEM one was. So the OEM one just like fit in that little slot down there. Now this new one is gonna fill out this little section right there along with all of this. So I'm gonna be able to cool down the intake air after the turbocharger, and I should in theory get more power that way. Now all that's gonna be for a future video. Stay tuned, I'll have a link for that in the description box once that video is out. Alrighty, so right here, I've got everything I need to mix up the proper coolant that I want to put into the Mini. So on the back side of the coolant container, it'll tell you what kind of ratio you want for whatever kind of temperature you're looking for. So the temperatures that I'm looking for are going to be more extreme than regular driving. So it says for regular driving, you're going to be mixing 50-50 antifreeze distilled water together inside the cooling system. So that's the ratio you'd want if you're just doing normal driving conditions. Now, if you're gonna be experiencing more high or more low temperatures than normal, what you're gonna wanna do is you're gonna mix 60% antifreeze, 40% distilled water. Now, by doing that, on the backside of here, it says that I'm gonna be able to protect my car against minus 52 degrees Celsius all the way up to positive 134 degrees Celsius. So that's gonna be great, especially considering that my car is gonna be here during the winter. It's not gonna be exposed to that low of temperatures, but when I bring it to the track, I'm gonna be seeing higher than normal temperatures. So that is a good thing. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna open this up. Then in this container, I've got 3.78 liters of pure, unmixed, unwhatevered coolant. And I'm gonna be putting all of that inside of this container. Now, the reason why I'm doing that is because I'm gonna be mixing all of this together, and I wanna make sure that I have a nice mixture for everything. So I'm just gonna finish the entire container of coolant and empty it inside of here. So I'm going for a 60-40 mix. So for the 3.78 liters of coolant that I'm putting in, I'm gonna be putting in 1.5 liters of water. Now this big container that I have right here that I'm pouring everything into is more than big enough to hold both the water and the coolant together. So I'm just gonna drain out the entire thing. Now I went to my local grocery store and picked up one of these distilled containers of water. It cost me like $1.10 or something like that. It was very cheap. Now you shouldn't be using tap water because there's extra minerals in there that you don't want to introduce into your cooling system. Now depending on the car, your system might be very sensitive to that mixture of water. One of my friends was telling me that the wrong kind of mixture, if you put inside your car, he experienced that the car that he was working on, he got backfires, misfires, and the car was running like crap because of the wrong coolant inside the car. It just goes to show on how important those ratios really are. So I'm gonna be putting 1.5 liters into here. And the reason why I'm doing that is because there's like a little meter on the side showing me how much water I need, or how much water is gonna be inside of here. So I'm looking for a little bit past that line on the bottom. And that right there looks to be right about in the halfway mark between here, or is it there? There's 1 liter, there's two. So it's right in between. I don't know how well the light's picking it up, but I promise you it's right about in that range. So now let's put the top back on there. And let's pour this into the coolant. Now once I do this, I'm gonna mix all of this up just to make sure that all of the coolant and water is mixed properly. If you have spots that are more coolant than water or more water than coolant, you might not get the same cooling and heating characteristics that you want from the coolant. So with that emptied, take that off. So I'm gonna grab this, give it a shake. And once I've got all of this nicely mixed up, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put a little bit of this into the expansion tank. And then at that point, I should be able to turn the car on and let it cycle and drain this through. Now, depending on your car, as soon as you put that coolant inside your expansion tank, it's just gonna start dropping. So right now, all the coolant that I'm putting in there is falling down and it's filling up all the lines that had air in it. Now, because I took all the lines out, they all should have air. So if I need to make a little bit more coolant, I know how to mix it. See that bubbling? That means that there's air down lower in some of the hoses and it's coming up, which is good. Now, I'm probably gonna see this more once I turn on the car and get this to cycle with the thermostat opened and closed. Now, I'm probably gonna have to turn the car on, let the thermostat open up, let it close, put more coolant inside the expansion tank if I need to, which I probably will have to, and I'm gonna have to do the same thing when I turn the heat on for the car. So allow the heat on the inside of the car to circulate through the heater core once the coolant gets warm enough. So from the looks of it, I'll probably have to make more. Now it's very easy. So I'm gonna do 60% coolant, 40% water, mix it up, and that's gonna be ready to put inside the car. Now guys, that's about as far as I'm gonna go for showing you what I'm gonna be doing with the coolant system for now. Now, down the road, if the water pump goes on me, I have no problem showing you guys how to replace that. And you know, it's gonna be fairly simple because we have most of the coolant system now new and out of the way. Now, all that I'm doing right now is preventative maintenance. Now, from there, I'll be able to upgrade the coolant system even more by maybe changing the fluid that I have in there. So the fluid that I have in there, I'll maybe change it come summertime to a dedicated race coolant, and it's gonna be a much better, you know, more tolerable to higher temperatures. Now, I haven't found any kind of upgraded rad for the Mini. There's nothing that I've found to be, you know, a thicker rad, a better rad, nothing. This is, the OEM one is all that I've found to be good, and you know, there's not really an upgrade from there. Like intercooler, I found an upgrade for that. The coolant lines, the intercooler lines, all that stuff, everything going to the rad as well. Like, I have the upgraded Mishimoto lines that we just plugged in to the rad, but there's no aftermarket rad out there for this Mini. So I guess the manufacturer thinks, you know, this rad is good enough and it doesn't need upgrading. When I bring it to the track, I'll definitely keep you guys up to date when that comes around, come springtime. And, you know, I'll take a look at the coolant temperatures, see if it's, you know, okay. See if the thermostat is working nicely along with this OEM rad. Now, that's as far as it goes, guys. If you guys have any questions regarding the video, throw it down in the comment section below. If you guys want to pick up any of the stuff that I used today, as always, you guys can check down in the description box. I'll have links to everything. So from the Mishimoto, the coolant lines, to all the stuff that I used today, including the part numbers, to the OEM stuff like the thermostat and that water pipe that broke at the back, you guys can check that down there as well. I'll have all the information there for you. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll see you in the next one. Peace.